ontology of the existence of God's beings I am revealing. You do not need to be fanatic or rock solid conclusion to live your life. Understand, binary logic teaches you, unless you come to the final conclusion, don't proceed. But don't you understand, in any field you cannot come to final conclusion. Knowledge cannot be dead. In any field, if knowledge, the final conclusion is reached, then that field is killed. If somebody tells you, this is your God, only one God, there is no other God, your consciousness is killed. Your religious progress is destroyed. Your spiritual growth is over. Understand, listen, in any field, come to cognition, not to conclusion. Cognitions can be upgraded. When more powerful cognitions come, you can raise to that. Actually, in Shakta Sampradaya, directly they will not even teach you the Devi Mantra. In Shakta Sampradaya, Parashakti, Parameshwari, Rajarajeshwari is the ultimate. They will not teach you her mantra and her worship directly. They will first make you feel connected to one God, then next God, then next God. Because your cognitions get matured along with your Ishta Devata, along with your God, chosen ideal. Whether in the outer world or in the inner world, understand, conclusions kills you, cognitions keeps you alive. Cognitions helps you to grow further and further and further. Conclusions kills you once for all. If you are feeling connected to Rama and enjoying Rama Bhakti, enjoy it absolutely. Don't come to conclusion, Rama is ultimate. Come to the cognition, Rama is ultimate. Because suddenly tomorrow, you may feel connected strongly with Hanuman, and that is perfectly accepted in Hindu tradition. And Rama himself will give you darshan as Hanuman. And suddenly, next day you feel connected to Paramashiva. Don't worry, it is accepted. Changing Ishta Devata, or same Ishta Devata, but changing the attitudes, bhava, or even changing the understanding about the Ishta Devata is allowed. In Hindu tradition, you may not change Ishta Devata, even the same Shiva. Initially you may feel like, Lord, oh, you are my Lord. Then slowly you may feel a little bit, I think he's my father, not just Lord, my father and mother. And I think he's my friend also. Hey, I feel he's sweet part of my life. Because all, even my secret things, he is supporting me. Even my secret desires, or even in my secret life, He is doing whatever I want. I think he is my secret life partner also. There is nothing to hide from him. I can tell everything, whatever I want. And he does for me. I think he is my secret life partner also. He is my beloved too. Then, hey, he is one with me. Before even I think he is there thinking in me as I think. So the connection, feeling connection, understanding evolves. Understand possibility for evolution. Possibility for evolving is kept alive when you cognize. First thing, do not always be arrogant to come to conclusion and then start the actions. Come to cognitions and start the actions, because the cognitions will get upgraded. If you come to conclusion and then act, after acting, sometimes even if you find the conclusion is not complete, you will not feel like upgrading yourself, because you already spent lot of time, lot of work you have done on that conclusion. You will feel, oh God, I am already married to this conclusion and lived so many years. Now why unnecessarily rock the boat? Anyhow, life is over. Let me somehow pull it, drag it on. That will be like an Indian marriage. Indian marriage is a unique term I have. Listen to this. Dragging with the old conclusions is a dead life. Better understand, cognitions are the core of your intelligence, and start acting. And then be ready for upgradation of that cognitions. This is the fundamental truth you need to have to function and have enlightenment. It is ontology of Paramashivajnana.